Hello, Teal Sky Heller here with Chugach Eagle River Living and Signature Real Estate. So I'm bringing you your winter wonderland tip, how to live better and enjoy the winter when you're living in Alaska. So this is a tip for driveway maintenance. Now, many of us, especially in Chugach and Eagle River, if you live up on the mountain, you've got a steep driveway, and sometimes you don't even have to be on the mountain. We're at the base of the mountain and we have a steep, windy driveway. This is called a sanding bucket. And what we use, you can kind of see it, it's just a trash can. What you want to make sure you have is a lid that snaps on really well. This is gonna sit out in the winter. We leave it out year round, so it's gotta have a good lid that snaps on. The other things you need is a bag of ice melt. This will fill up 2 to 3 cans of gravel or sand, so you don't have to go overboard with the ice melt. Next, you'll need a shovel. And what you can't really see here is you'll need a truck bed, drop that, or some other form of sand. You can buy sand by the bag for 30, 35 bucks. You can get a truckload of it from Klondike and then just bring it back home and fill your cans. I really recommend that you fill your cans in place. Once you get these babies filled up, they are tough to move. So this can is set on a strategic point in our driveway. It comes down, makes a real tight turn. You can kind of see where we've already sanded the driveway behind me. But the winter's coming with more snow, and that means more times to sand. With this can, you're gonna start with it empty, and you're gonna fill it with, you're gonna get some sand, gravel. We like it as sandy as possible. What you don't want to do is put a bunch of rocks on your driveway. You want it real smooth. So once you get a covering, you know, probably 4 to 4 inches or so, you're going to switch. Now this is a bag of ice melt I already have open. So I'm going to take a shovel full of ice melt and I'm going to sprinkle in a layer of ice melt. You don't need that much. In fact, a full shovel full was a little bit too much. And then I'm going to keep going with the sand. Now, when I get done with loading up this barrel or trash can, I'm going to have a whole bunch of layers of sand, about 4 inches thick, a sprinkle of salt or ice melt, whatever you decide to use, another layer of sand, another layer of ice melt, all the way up the can to the very top. What that does, if you just have sand in this barrel and any moisture gets in, even like the naturally occurring moisture in the sand, it will freeze solid. So the ice melt keeps your sand nice and loose and movable. So when that time comes to sand the driveway, you've got a bucket with its snap-on lid that you just snap off that lid and you're ready to go with sand that's easy on your driveway and, you know, it's not real rocky like native soil would be. And the ice melt really helps with the sand. Now, if, you know, just be aware, the salt does affect your lawn, so you don't want to get it onto your garden areas or your lawn. But in terms of keeping a supply of sand, you put it on strategic places in your driveway, seal that lid tight after you fill it, it's ready to go. You can keep a shovel handy near the garbage can, but be aware it will freeze into whatever you stick it into. So we keep ours in the garage. And anytime we need to sand that driveway, we just fill it up from our cans. Now we use 3 cans because we have an S-shaped driveway. And so each curve has a can on it. And then we have one at the top that enables us to sand our parking area really easily. So the goal of these cans, not only to have something ready to go no matter what the weather is, but it's also to make life easy on you. No more looking for ice melt or sand. It's right handy. We fill these cans up once every 2 to 3 years. It does take a while to use them up, and we found them to be incredibly effective at making life easier when living in the last frontier. So thank you for joining me once again. I'm Teal Sky Heller with Chugach Eagle River Living and Signature Real Estate, and I'm